हेलो हेलो, माइक टेस्ट। हाँ, हेलो फाइनेंशियल प्रोग्रामर्स, आई एम ऋत्विक दशोरा एंड आई एम बैक विद अ न्यू वीडियो एंड सम न्यू लर्निंग्स। इफ यू वांट टू मेक योर लाइफ्स इजी बाय क्रिएटिंग योर ओन फंक्शंस इन पाइन स्क्रिप्ट एंड वांट टू लर्न इन द इजीएस्ट वे, देन यू आर एट द राइट प्लेस। एंड दिस वीडियो विल लर्न हाउ टू डिक्लेयर फंक्शंस इन पाइन स्क्रिप्ट एंड हाउ टू यूज देम in the most efficient way. We'll talk about single line functions, multi-line functions, getting multiple outputs using just one function, etc., etc. If it's your first time watching my YouTube videos, on this channel I make videos related to trading bots, implementation of AI in finance using some highly valuable finance APIs such that all my viewers become successful financial programmers. So if this is something you're interested in, then hit on the subscribe button and also click on the bell icon. Quick shout out to my Patreon members Edmund and the Pirate School. The topics that we are going to cover today are, we'll see how to declare functions in TradingView PineScript. As I mentioned in the beginning, we'll talk about the single line function declaration, multi-line function declaration. Then we'll see some of the examples, how to do that. Very important thing, which is multiple output function declaration and how to use them. It's a very, very important thing. And the last thing would be, I'll be building a cross above function, although it's already present in the, I would say, inbuilt functions in PineScript. But still, we'll make our own cross above function here. And then we'll plot all these things on the plot. Let's start with the code now. So guys, the use of any function in PineScript or Python or any programming language is that we define it, we declare it in the beginning, and then we use it later such that we don't need to repeat all those lines of the code again and again in the entire code. And similar to declaration of the functions we did in Python in my previous videos, we are going to do the same thing here in PineScript as well. As you already know, it starts with indicator, and then I'm just writing my script here. If you remember, in Python what we used to do is def, and then we name that particular function, which is like, say, fun, and then we provide all the inputs into it, x comma y, and then colon, right? In PineScript, it's a bit different. So what we do here is we use is equal to and then a greater than sign, right? This refers to defining or declaring a function. So the function is, for example, f x comma y, right? And then it's a single line function, single line. And say we just want to do x plus y divided by 2. So that's it. This is how we can define a single line function. Now what we can do is say a1 is equal to f of open and close. Right, so what it's going to do is it will take an average of open and close, right? And if we just plot a1 here, you'll see, let me just save it, declaring functions, video 5. If we add to the chart, we can see that this particular series has been plot on this chart. You guys already know, if you write overlay is equal to true, then you'll see that control s and then add to chart, you'll see that this particular chart will come on the same chart. So you cannot see this, but yeah, it's actually overlapping on the already existing candlesticks, right? So this is the single line function. In order to write a multi-line function, what you need to do here is just like press enter here and provide an indentation, that is by pressing a tab button. That's it, right? So this is a multi-line function. It's very useful when the function is quite big in size. You need to introduce many variables in mid, and then you need to use it later. So in that case, we should actually write a multi-line function, because it's very easy to interpret and there's a very less possibility of errors. But in this case, you just see that although I've provided it in two lines, we can just do it in this one line as well. So I've written this line, and I'm introducing a function called EMA spread. It's an example of how I'm using a single line function. So EMA spread is the name of the function. Length is input number one. Bars back is input number two. And then after that, I'm introducing it by, I would say, declaring it by using this particular operator, which is equal to and then greater than sign. TA dot EMA close comma length. Minus ta dot ema close comma length and then bars back. So what it is doing is it is actually subtracting exponential moving average of two different time intervals, right? That's a very, very basic function, but yeah, if you use it, let me just plot it here. For example, let me do it like this, ema spread, and rather than this, I'll just write length to be equal to, say, 40, and bars back is 10. Right, if we save it, you'll see that in the end or something. Yeah, so you can see somewhere around zero, it is, we are getting a graph, we are getting a line graph. So because like it's subtracting to EMS, it's coming somewhere around zero only. Now this particular function can be used for further analysis as well, and you don't need to write this line again and again. Now what if we want to get multiple outputs through just one function? Then in that case we need to use a square bracket, right? So yeah, you can see I have written a function here which is fun fun x comma y. I'm introducing a function, it's a multi-line function. Why? Because I am actually using a lot of, I would say, variables. I'm using two variables here, that's why it's it requires multi lines, multiple lines. So a is equal to x plus y, b is equal to x minus y, and the output that I want is both a and b. So I want to provide them in a square bracket. So now what, in order to like save it in different variables, we need to provide it in the same way. So a square bracket var1 comma var2, this will be the name of the these two variables, and in the end we just need to provide fun and in parenthesis open comma close, or like whatever you want to provide it in the inputs. But yeah, the output will be a and b both. So variable 1, which is var1, will be is equal to a, and var2 is would be equal to b. Now let's just write cross above function. So we need to know, we need to have a boolean, a true or a false, whenever the price crosses EMA value, for example, right? So in that case, I'm just writing a function here. Cross above is the name of the function. Inputs are price and length, and then EMA value is equal to ta.ema price comma length, right? Above is equal to, it will be a boolean. So it is equal to price is greater than EMA value. So whenever the price is greater than EMA value, it will be true. And I'm using an AND operator where the price, the last candle price or last bar price is less than the last bar EMA value. Then in that case only we get to know that, yeah, it has crossed the EMA price and it's now above the EMA series. And then in the end, I need to provide above, like the last line, last statement is above, because this is the output that we want. It's exactly similar to this one. So this was the output that we wanted. Here above is the output that I want. And then yeah, definitely we can use this particular thing for the further analysis as well. So yeah, it's a very simple concept. A quick information to all my viewers, if you want to get a free access of my Google Drive where I save many codes, then you just need to click here on my YouTube page, which is access to my Google Drive button, and then just follow some steps over there. The Google Drive that I'm talking about, it has many codes related to the work that I've done in the past, and you just need to provide some basic informations, and I'll just provide a free access of my Google Drive to all the eligible members. Also, one lucky subscriber will get a chance to speak to me via Zoom call. If you're still watching this video, please hit on the like button, guys. It's really important for the algorithm. Comment what all different types of topics that you want me to cover in the future. And the next videos that I'm going to cover in the future will be on Indian stock market data for both NSE and BSE. Also, please consider the premium services that I provide on Patreon community and see the list of things that I do over there. Very recently, I published a post over there where I talked about stepping target price and stop loss on PineScript. I'm going to be very active on that particular community. For any freelancing requests, just write an email to me on this email address. Thank you so much for watching this video till the end. You can click here to subscribe to my YouTube channel. Over there, you can see how I built a trading bot on Python. And over there, you can check out this entire playlist of TradingView to learn PineScript in the easiest way on YouTube. And I'll see you in the next video. Thank you.